Many 3D Benchy models are disappearing. But why? Let's take a look at what just happened, which companies are involved, which models are safe, who's in danger, and what would be needed to turn all the models legal. I'm Everson, once more, I'm not a lawyer, and this time it would be more useful if I was a private investigator. What happened? Some of the Benchys you know just got removed from Printables. The 3D Benchy itself is fine, and it will always be fine. What about all the other Benchys? It depends. To help us out, let's play a quiz! First question. Can you download the 3D Benchy, 3D print it, and sell it? I mean, legally. Can you sell it? Yes or no? Yes, you can! The authors chose a Creative Commons license that allows distribution, even commercially. And you can sell it forever, because the license is irrevocable. But you cannot sell just the Benchy. The license requires you to give credit to the creator. So it should at least include a piece of paper giving proper credit to the author, mentioning the license. You also cannot imply endorsement or favoritism by the creator. Second question. Can you modify the 3D Benchy? I mean, legally. Are you allowed to modify it? Yes or no? Yes, you can. For personal use. You can make experimentations, post videos and photos about them, but we are not allowed by the license to share or distribute these modifications. And this is the no derivatives term of the license. I cannot share the SVG laser files of my cardboard 3D Benchy. One more question. If the creators decide to delete the 3D Benchy from Thingiverse, can you re-upload it? Yes or no? Yes, now, today, if you want. Matter of fact, on Printables, the Benchy was uploaded by Prusa Research themselves. And on Maker World, the Benchy was uploaded by someone else. But I'm sorry, J-Ray, you informed a different license. Not only it causes confusion, but this upload can be removed from the platform. Removed? By whom? Who owns the copyright of the original Benchy? The 3D Benchy was created in 2015 by Daniel Noré and Paulo Kieff at the company Creative Tools. There is a great interview where they explain they needed a unique, challenging object for themselves to compare the quality of their own 3D printers, a benchmark with different features. They want the model to be used and shared as much as possible. But why did they choose the no derivative license? They wanted the model to be a calibration tool. Nobody should alter or tweak the model itself, just the print settings. And I believe it was a legitimate reason at the time because both Daniel and Paulo are champions of open source themselves. The community loved the Benchy so much that it grew big, not just as a tool, but also as an art form, humor, and sometimes even a political expression. Nobody should have shared their modified models, but everybody did. Creative Tools embraced this mashup culture. Many of the models were featured and celebrated in their social channels. The no derivative aspect of the license was never enforced. Until today. On Reddit, Maker Joe shared that his glitched Benchy was removed from Printables. His model was a derivative. Another company, NTI Group, acquired Creative Tools in March 2024. So it must be NTI, right? It is natural to assume their acquisition included the 3D Benchy, its YouTube channel, the 3DBenchy.com website, merchandising products, and the copyright of the model. But we don't know that. It was not disclosed. Maybe the Benchy was not part of the deal. Maybe someone else owns it now. According to this 3D printing industry article, NTI says the derivatives removal wasn't them. Printables is saying they responded to a third-party report. They couldn't disclose who was it. but they confirmed it was not filed by NTI. To make things more confusing, at the same time, the 3DBenchy.com website got completely blank, no content. And the official 3DBenchy YouTube channel is also gone. Erasing the website and the YouTube channel was part of the plan, or did someone hack them? I wonder, because while I write this, the website came back, but the YouTube channel is not. Because of the no derivatives license, many of the community models are at stake. Which ones? And who's safe? Let's play another game.
Safe for Sony!
The point is to determine if a model is an original or a derivative under the CC BY ND license. Let's start easy. Benchy holder for multiboard. It doesn't come with a Benchy, it doesn't contain geometry extracted from the Benchy, it's an accessory. Looks like it's safe. Sinking Benchy. Well, it is clear that it used the geometry of the Benchy and combined it with a low poly C. By the time you watch this video, it might be gone, and I am very sorry. What about this Benchy Wave? It doesn't come with a Benchy, it is just the C, and the text is not here. But we know the geometry of the Benchy was used to boolean out this hole. If the original geometry was used as a tool to produce it, isn't this part a derivative?
Oh, come on!
I don't know! Tell me in the comments! It gets very subtle and convoluted. If you use the geometry as a starting point, it is a modification. I don't think this one is safe. Maybe if it's completely independent from the original mesh. This Benchy is parametric, made using Onshape. It was uploaded as a step file for high quality, and it was taken down. After all, it is recognizable. It looks just like the Benchy. And here's a problem. Try to upload an STL model of a hat that looks like this. See the point? Is any model that intentionally makes you remember of the 3DBenchy really safe? Because if the owner ever tries to explore the 3DBenchy as a trademark, there is no limit to the legal appetite, and we will be sorry for this, or even this, or whatever. So far, the removals were only on printables. I wish the situation would be a terrible prank, or a regretful marketing decision, and they get back. Whoever holds the 3DBenchy's copyright, I have a question for you. Creative tools don't exist anymore. It doesn't even make sense to keep attributing credit to it. Why don't you release the Benchy under CC0? After all, how much valuable would be a brand whose community doesn't love it anymore? On a personal level, this Benchy episode feels a lot like my bricklayer's patent video. Once more, we have the 3D printing community feeling constrained and betrayed. On the bricklayers, we at least found prior art and there are developments going on. But with the Benchy, it is a third party's copyright. The truth is, we've all been creating culture on top of something that was never truly ours. The articles, the interview, and any new information that comes up, everything will be in the description. I'm Everson, and thank you so much for watching.